Spoiler alert! The following post discusses the ending of Venom, Let There Be Carnage, so beware if you haven't seen it yet. Venom's made a home for himself on the big screen after two movies, and now it looks like he's headed for a larger superhero universe, although time will tell which one. In the new sequel Venom, Let There Be Carnage, journalist Eddie Brock, Tom Hardy, and the violent, sardonic and kind of fun-loving alien symbiote inside of him, also voiced by Hardy, overcame their differences to defeat supervillain lovebirds Carnage, Woody Harrelson, and Shriek, Naomie Harris, and, naturally, that means vacation time for the reconnected best friends, though their relaxing getaway gets awfully crazy and features a surprising guest star. Venom's long tongue is seen licking Peter's image, and he cryptically says, "That guy." So does this mean Venom's now the newest member of the MCU? If so, the weird situation in the hotel room might hint at Eddie/Venom getting caught up in the dramas of the multiverse, a sandbox of alternate realities that Disney's Marvel movies and TV shows are currently exploring. Who wouldn't want to campaign in some aspect to say, "Hey, I'm playing Venom. I want to be accepted in the Marvel canon," even though all of the children are spread across two different parents, Hardy recently told USA Today with a grin. "I appreciate Terry's a lot of legal issues here, but more family." The coming film Spider-Man, No Way Home, in theaters December 17th, teams Spidey and sorcerer Doctor Strange, Benedict Cumberbatch, for a multiverse-bending adventure dealing with Peter's secret identity reveal, and other Spidey foes fro. More likely, though, the Venom Stinger sets up a place for Hardy's antihero to exist in Sony's fledgling Spidey-centric galaxy as it goes its own way, spinning off from the MCU. Contributing, Andrea Mandell.